we are rolling out some new protocols to allow people to start playing sports again and to allow many businesses to start getting back into business.
The state is easing restrictions for restaurants, movie theaters, sports, and more. The governor said months of mask wearing and social distancing helped to get us here.
We have team coverage of what these changes mean for you. Let's begin with King 5's Vanessa Mashanya.
The loosened restrictions come as good news for many, as libraries like the Magnolia Library here can now reopen, some youth sports can resume, and more people will be allowed inside of restaurants, a saving grace as winter approaches.
We are beginning to see the fruits of our masking, distancing, and sanitizing.
I'm really pleased to say that our efforts are showing progress.
Today, Governor Inslee announced the loosening of restrictions around restaurants, businesses, and youth sports.
We are rolling out some new protocols to allow people to start playing sports again and to allow many businesses to start getting back into business.
Businesses like movie theaters, 85% of all of them in our state can now reopen. Libraries, too, at 25% in phase two counties.
This is a good day.
There's also changes to restrictions at restaurants, something Anthony Anton of the Washington Hospitality Association is excited about. Table sizes in phase two and three counties are increasing to 6, and alcohol sales are extending to 11 p.m.
This allows that dinner party to order that bottle of wine at 10 o'clock. This allows people to enjoy an appetizer, enjoy another round.
Also, parties consisting of multiple households are allowed.
This was such a challenging one, this particular rule to enforce. I think the governor was recognizing it was a challenge to enforce on this particular rule. And I did think that led to moving forward.
Restaurants and bars continue to reel from the pandemic. Though things are opening back up, the industry is still down 100,000 jobs. With winter coming and outdoor seating not an option, Anton says this is a good step, but it is not an answer to all their troubles.
Our hope is, while these steps are really positive and we're very appreciative of them, we plead with our communities to keep wearing masks and help us bring the numbers down, because we need to have future conversations in the upcoming months.
On that note, Anton says, while most patrons have been complying with the guidelines, some restaurants have noticed some troubles with patrons wearing masks or getting up around tables and mingling. And he just urges everyone to remember to keep complying with the guidelines when we go out to eat, so one day we can dine as we once did as soon as possible. In Seattle, Vanessa Mashanya, King 5 News.
All right, Vanessa, thank you. So Vanessa mentioned recreational sports as part of the governor's announcement. That is a big sigh of relief for leagues barely hanging on after months of being shut down. King 5's Britt Moore has that part of our story.
The owner I spoke with and other youth and adult recreational sports leagues are holding their breath tonight that sometime soon in the coming days they can get their businesses back up and running. The governor's announcement today providing some relief, but also sparking more questions.
It's been tough. I mean, second week in March, we just shut down permanently, and we haven't been able to run since.
Adult and youth recreation sports leagues like Comeback Sports, based out of Tacoma, have been on pause for more than 6 months. Before today, golf and pickleball have been the only sports being played in the league.
It's been really a challenge, but we do see a little glimmer of hope here.
Co-owner Dave Mincinitas says his money-making sport is softball. Without it, his business will continue to struggle.
We need this to survive right now, so we're hoping we can go. We want to go. We've been waiting to go. We've been ready.
Governor Inslee's latest update to COVID-19 restrictions will mean sports leagues can get back to business safely as long as certain county metrics are met. Counties with moderate COVID activity or between 25 and 75 cases per 100,000 people over 14 days can resume low to moderate risk level sports. That includes softball. A relief for a league that says it's already come up with a plan to keep players and staff safe once it gets the go-ahead.
Even having an on-site COVID-specific supervisor that would make sure that we're enforcing social distancing, cleansing, and different things that we wanted to have in place.
Mencenita says after months of being shut down, he's eager and excited to get the games going again.
People are just chomping at the bit to play. We just need to get going, you know, and we want to be able to give that outlet to them.
Based on the updated guidance, for the most part, tournaments and fans are still not allowed. That includes adult and youth recreational games. In Seattle, Britt Moore, King 5 News.